In this After Effects tutorial, I'll show you how to create this glossy title intro animation. Hi guys, my name is Manuel. It's the clean and modern kind of glossy, not the cheesy kind you see all the time. And I'll show you some nice tricks along the way. So let's get started. With a comp, we name it title animation or whatever. HD resolution, 3 seconds long. Next, we add a solid. Color doesn't matter. The background. We use the effects and presets window to add a gradient ramp. We move the start to the bottom left corner, the end to the top right corner, for a diagonal direction. Then we change the colors, from a very dark blue, almost black, to a dark purple. We add lots of ramp scatter to avoid color bending. Then we choose the title tool and add our text. Whatever you want the title to be, title animation. Size around 100, the font doesn't matter. We left align the text and move it to the top left corner. We right click onto the layer and make it a guide layer, meaning you see it in the preview, but it won't be rendered. Let's name the layer text. With no layer selected, we grab the title tool again. Type in a few random letters. This time I use a font called Didoni URWD, which is available on Adobe fonts. We use the outline instead of a fill, stroke width 2 pixels. We set the size to 1296 pixels, which is the max size, I believe. Tracking to 50, and let's change the outline color to orange. We open both source text properties and link the upper property to the one below. Why that? It'll make sense later, I promise. Important is 2 layers, same text. We name the top layer outline orange. Okay, let's see. We scale it up to around 150% and position it on the screen so that we see the beginning of the text. We duplicate the text layer and change the name to outline white. And set the outline color to white, of course. With the layer selected, we use the rectangle tool to add a mask, like this. Then we rotate it, position it in the center. Open the mask property and add a mask feather along the x-axis. Let's narrow the shape a little bit. Alright, and let's set the guide layer for now. We duplicate the orange outline one more time, move it below this time, name it fill, because we use the fill this time. Then we copy the gradient ramp from the background and paste it to the text layer. Swap the colors and reduce the opacity to 50%. And add a drop shadow. We set the softness to around 1000, so it's really soft. Finally, we link the 2 bottom text layers to the top one. We open its mask property and set a keyframe, as well as for the position property. We set the endpoints of the layers to 1 second. 1 frame before, we move the text to the left by a few letters. Then we move the mask back to the right edge. We select all 4 keyframes, open the graph editor, and slow down the beginning of the animation as much as possible. Off the position and the mask. Awesome. Before moving to the next part, let's take a quick moment to look at the 750 plus Motion Graphics Advanced Pack. It comes with its own extension, so you can preview all elements directly in After Effects. From fully animated slideshows to transitions, shape elements, title animations, and lower thirds, and so much more. Let's apply this big title to our comp with just 1 click. Let's go into the comp and change the text. How about combining it with an animated background? Again, we go into the comp, adjust the colors in the control layer. Plus, let's add animated lines at the beginning. It's that easy and fast. make sure to check out the link in the description below. This pack will save you a lot of time doing client work, which you can use to create unique stuff for yourself, for example. Link is in the description. Alright, the second part of the tile animation. We duplicate the three layers and move them to 1 second in the timeline. We delete all keyframes, then scale the top layer up to around 500%. Next, we position it, find a nice cutout, part of the T and I maybe, and we adjust the mask position. Move it to the right edge. Let's zoom back in here. We set a position keyframe. Next, we move the text to the left again. Now we need to make sure that this feels like one fluent movement. That's too slow, so further to the left. That's much better. Then we set a mask keyframe at the beginning. And at the end, we move the mask back to the right edge. The animation in this part is linear. Let's see. Alright, let's get to the third and last part. We duplicate the fill layer once more, move it to the top of the layer stacking order, and move it to the right. Delete the link and set the scale back to 100%. Let's position it so that the left part of the tile is visible. We set a position keyframe at the beginning. At the end, we move it further to the left by a few letters. We open the graph editor and slow down the end of the animation as much as possible. Again, we make sure it feels like one smooth animation. Awesome. Next, we duplicate the orange outline. Move it above the fill layer, delete the link. We scale it down to 100%. Plus this time, we use the fill instead of the stroke. And we reduce the font size even further to 100 pixels. And where is it? Center align the text. And align the layer to the center using the alignment tool. Then we set a position keyframe at the end. At the beginning, we move the text to the right, halfway out of the screen. Then we open the graph editor again and slow down the end of the animation as much as possible. Let's see. Okay, this is what we don't want. Both layers have the exact same speed. So we slow down the background layer. That's nice. We duplicate the layer, change the fill color to white. Then use the rectangle tool again to add a mask. Then add a mask feather. We rotate it. We move it to the right. At the end, set a keyframe. At the beginning, we move it to the left edge of the tile. Again, you know it. We open the graph editor and slow down the end as much as possible. One more thing we could do is go to the end, delete the position keyframes of the lower text layer, and link it to the top one instead. Finally, let's add flashes. We add a new solid, color white, name it Flash. 6 frames long, so we adjust the endpoint. We double-click on the ellipse tool to add a mask. Then we add a mask feather of around 750 pixels. And let's expand the mask by around 150 pixels. We set the opacity of the layer to 100% in the middle, then to 0 in the beginning, and back to 0 at the end. Then we move the middle, where the opacity is 100%, over the first cut. We duplicate the layer and move it over the second cut. Quick and easy. We created the guide layer to be able to easily change the text. Instead of changing it in each text layer, there's one for all. And that's it. Check out the links in the description. On the left side, I've added some videos you might like. Subscribe to my channel on the right side and hit the bell, because you don't want to miss my next video. Thanks for watching this one. See you in the next one. Bye, guys.